With iOS 17 comes an easier way to manage data in SwiftUI apps. In this video, let's discover SwiftUI's groundbreaking ESB architecture, that is the environment-state bindable architecture. Master environment, state, and bindable for efficient data management. Join me as we explore global data access, local manipulation, and seamless data binding. Go ahead and check out my summer sale. The link is down in the description. So today we are going to talk about data handling in SwiftUI 5, that is iOS 17. And I have created already a data handling in SwiftUI epic video on that, but that was SwiftUI 4. Now things have changed quite dramatically, so we are going to address those. I am using Xcode 15 beta 2, so make sure that you are on at least on a beta 2. So what I have here is a simple app with a content view. So we are going to take a look at the ESB architecture, that is environment state bindable architecture. So I have my content view, but we are going to also navigate. So first thing that I will do right over here is create a new SwiftUI view, that is the detail view. Detail view, just like that. Let's create it. And that's it. I'm going to just say hello, detail view for our text right over there. Great. Okay, next up, we want to talk about this ESB architecture. What is the environment, the state, and the binding? Because previously we had state object, observable object, observed of that, published, all of that stuff. Now it's really, really straightforward and simple. Calling all SwiftUI enthusiasts, it's time to ignite your development journey with my exclusive summer sale. Enjoy an incredible 70% discount on all my top-notch SwiftUI products. Don't miss this golden opportunity to level up your skills at an unbeatable price. The discounted link is in the description. Go there now and unlock the full potential of your SwiftUI projects with my amazing summer sale. So, we have our content view, and MVVM, you might have a view model in this content view. So I would just call this not view model, but view state. So I'm going to add it onto this file, into this particular file. I'm going to make it file private, so it can be accessible only on this file, only on the content view. So this will be a file private class. View state, and I'm going to have only one property right over here. Var is detail view presented, and the default value will be false. Okay, so if you know SwiftUI 4 previously, how we made this could be an observable object, and then we have our published variable is detail view presented, but we don't have to do that at all in SwiftUI 5. All we have to do is just add the @observable property wrapper right over here. @observable. It's not a property wrapper, it's actually a macro. So @observable, file private class view state. So now we can access this file private on the content view, and we access it not through a state object, just simply through the new polished state. So @state. Private, yeah, it's going to be private, so you know we cannot initialize the content view with it. Var view state, there we go, and this is our view state. There we go, this is our view state. So now we can actually use this. So what I'm going to do is just create a simple button. So let's just have our button right over here with a title of detail view, and the action, well, we just go view state dot is detail view presented dot toggle, and just a few lines of code. It's so fantastic. It's as easy as that. So let's build and run and let's see how that looks like. But before we do that, let's just add in here our sheet with the is presented and content dollar view state dot is detail view presented. That's what we are binding it to. And the content is our detail view. Okay, let's hit command R don't ask me again, and replace. Command R to build and run, and tapping on detail view will just present that sheet. It's really, really nice with just a few lines of code, as I told you. Okay, so that is our observable, and this is our state. So what we want to do basically is just not have only these view states, these MVVM style view models. I want this to be available throughout our application. So I want this to be on an app level, not just a view level observable. So for that, we are going to use a person. So let's just create our model right over here. So let's create a new file, Swift file, next, person. And that will be just a simple struct person, the simplest struct that we could just have here, var a name of string, and it's equals an empty. Or we could just make it even shorter, just like that. Okay, so now we could just use this person and have it available throughout our application. And for that, we would just create another observable, which will be put into the environment. So let me just show you how easy it is to do that. We're going to create another Swift file. Let's name this app state, or you can just create any other state like profile state, settings or service state, whatever. I'm going to name it app state, and I'm going to import Swift UI and then create an observable class with a small c there. Class app state, and we are going to create our person. Our person equals person, that's right. And I'm also going to create some logic right over here. Let's just add a function of fetch person, there we go. And that's going to basically have person equals our person initialized with the name of Ada. And basically that's it. Now that we have our app state ready, we need to have it available throughout our application. And you can just add this basically on any kind of root level that you choose. But currently I'm just going to go all the way to the content view for the root of our application. And again, we are going to use state. It's as easy as that. So let's have a private state variable and equals app state. And what we want to do is set it up as an environment. So if you type out environment, you will see that there's a new one with this observable object. So we are going to add that app state right over there. Okay, so now that we have the environment, how can we access it? Well, it's as simple as grabbing the environment on our view. So you just go at environment, open parentheses, and then you want to set up the observables protocol. So basically the name of our observable, so appState.self var appState, come on, state. And basically that's it. We have maybe we could just make this private. There we go. So now we can just access our app state and our profile. So let's just have a little bit of fun right over here. Let's have a text for our app state dot person dot name. So we are going to display our name, and then we are going to have a button right over here with the title of fetch, and then the action would be our app state dot fetch person. So let's hit command R and let's see how that is going to look like. There we go. We just go fetch, and Ada has been added onto that text, which is really nice. By the way, the detail view is still working as expected. Okay, so that's the easiest way to just add in an environment. But what if I want to change this name? I want to bind this to a text field. Well, you could create a bindable. Now, you cannot actually add, so let me just add in here a text field just for just showing you to try this out. So we're just going to have a name, and the text would be, you see, it's accepting a binding of time stream. So you could just type out app state, but as you can see, it's not auto-completing dot person dot name, but you know, it's not going to access this. So for that, we need to create a binding. So we are going to create a new file, SwiftUI view, next. And that will be bindable text field. Okay, so now we just create. And right over here, I'm going to just simply copy out our text field. So this is actually what we want. So I'm going to cut it out actually. So putting it right over here, we are going to need this app state. So how do we get it? Well, with the bindable. So add bindable var app state of type app state. And there you have it. Now we have a bindable. So, of course, we can just remove the preview. So right over here on the content view, now we can just use our bindable text field with our app state. So just pass along our app state and it should just work as expected. So there we go. If we just type in here, maybe whatever, Bob. There we go. It is binded as expected. Now, this is kind of an extra step. I don't really like making custom bindable views in our SwiftUI app. Therefore, there's an easier way. So let me just comment that out and let's just type out again our text field. And we have our title key of a name. And then here we need actually a bindable. So let's just have a bindable with a wrapped value. Now the wrapped value is our app state. And then we can just access the person.name. And if we hit Command R, you will see that it's everything as it should be. So either right over there, or Bob right over there. It's really, really fantastic. Now, if you did like this video about data handling, make sure to check out the new iOS 17 Swift Data CRUD. The video is right over here.